Hi and welcome to this new video. In this video I want to introduce you to the FIFA Oslo. Maybe you remember I already did a video about this, where I unboxed it and I had a first listen, but then I had to return it as I had a battery issue and I got a FIFA Copenhagen instead, and today I'm here with a brand new perfect unit. Of course, this isn't a unit which I bought on my own, this is a review sample from my store, so yeah, a big thank you. But maybe I can keep it, or maybe I also have to give it back, I'm not sure, but let's use the time to do some testing. In the store it was newly sealed, but we had to unbox it and I checked if it is a perfectly working unit, and I found out that it is one of the very rare perfect units, as many FIFA units have problems like, I don't know, farting noises from the back radiator, some are, I don't know, not really right sounding, some have a very strange frequency response, and my old unit had a battery issue so it didn't charge, it only worked when it was plugged in, and when it was plugged off it simply turned itself off. And somehow the battery was broken, but like I said, this unit is perfect, everything works just 100% fine. It's also the perfect color for me. So yeah, let me give you some specs. It has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 drivers built in. 2 full range drivers here, I think they are 50mm. 2 base drivers at the front and at the back firing like this, which are, I think 65mm. And at the sides we have some passive radiators. Not open, but under this metal thing here, which are in the flat sandwich design. They might have some farting noises as there is a little gap between them and the metal, so yeah, there might are some farting noises, but it isn't too strong. Only at maximum volume with very heavy recordings you might hear some farting, just because the space between the radiator and the metal is so little that the airflow might be too strong. With the Copenhagen, which is the next bigger model, which is just twice the size, but I think the same sound, doesn't have this as the passive radiators are at the front, but I think they wanted to keep it very small, so they did it like this. At the back we have all of our ports and our buttons. There's only one button. This is the volume button, the charging port, the service port, which is micro USB, an auxiliary port, you also get an auxiliary cable in the box, a reset button and a battery LED. I think it is green from 80 to 100%, orange from 30 or 20 to 80%, and I think red from 20 to 80%, from 0 to 20%. I would say that we will just have a sound check. Oh, I forgot, at the front we have our volume buttons, which are nicely made. I'm already connected. So let's try to compare it against the next bigger model, the FIFA Copenhagen. This has some more drivers built in, so it has 4 passive radiators and 2 tweeters additionally to the normal drivers, and even bigger woofers. So we will see if it really sounds better, or if the 2 years between the Copenhagen and the Oslo really brought some new innovations. We will also compare it against the brand new B&O M5. Which is, I think, $100 more expensive and also not battery powered, but I can show it to you. It is also a bit smaller, a bit deeper, but not as high as the FIFA Oslo. And this will be very exciting, as many people asked me for a comparison. So let's just get right into the comparison. Of course, you should wear some headphones, as I'm recording it with binaural microphones and they require headphones to sound good. So just put up your headphones and enjoy. So let's first compare it against the bigger brother, the FIFA Copenhagen. Back when it was released, I think in 2014, it was about $700. Now the price has dropped to $600, so a very expensive speaker. I think it is a little bit of a step back from the FIFA Oslo, as it is exactly twice the size, so the Oslo is the Copenhagen just split in half, and it also has some flaws. Yeah, my buttons sound quite strange. It has some very strong self-discharging going on. The battery only lasts for about 3 to 6 hours, and on the Oslo for about 8 to 10 hours. And it also doesn't really work with the app, only via Wi-Fi. So if you connect via Wi-Fi, it will work with the app, but not via Bluetooth. It also doesn't have the typical late night mode. It has one, but this late night mode doesn't boost some bass. It only reduces the mids, which makes it very soft sounding. So it is a bit of a step back over the Oslo. But I still like the sound, as it sounds very big and powerful and relaxed all the time. But now you should have a listen for yourself. The FIFA Oslo is playing in the late night mode, the Copenhagen in the neutral mode, as the late night doesn't really give you an extra of sound. So let's try this new track here.
Seek love before your eyes. So
should turn the Oslo to the neutral mode, as this track is very heavy recorded and there might be some, yeah, I don't know, uncleanness in the bass right now, as they are already playing at about, yeah, I think 70% of the full volume, so quite loud. Maybe the app will work, if not we will just leave it in late night. But so far I would say the sound isn't half as good as the Copenhagen, it is the exact same or even better. I think here you can say less is more. In the neutral mode it has a bit less bass, a bit less, I don't know, sound stage, but this makes it more exciting sounding. I don't know, this is very strange. So now let's try another track, also some bass area stuff by Nigel Good. This track I would prefer the FIFA Copenhagen, as it just sounded a bit bigger. Now it really can use these huge drivers, but yeah, in a comparison the Oslo really could stack up very nicely, although it didn't have this, yeah, soundstage bass power, but it still was very nice and far, very punchy sounding, which I also of course like. Maybe you are wondering why the Copenhagen sounds a bit more covered. This might also be because of the tweeters firing like this and not like this. The Oslo, like I said, has two full-range drivers. Maybe they are the same as in the Helsinki, but the Copenhagen has two additional tweeters over here, so maybe I would have to stand like this, but I think this would be unfair for the Oslo then. So yeah, it is very hard to find a sweet spot. Let's try a jazz track now. Other than the soundstage, I like the FIFA Oslo more. Of course, this is a bit unfair, as the Copenhagen has the drivers like this and the Oslo, of course, like this, more nearby than with the Copenhagen. But the mids were more sparkling, the treble was a bit more refined, although the Copenhagen has tweeters, the same as the FIFA Stockholm, which is the most big FIFA product. But I think the Oslo had an advantage here, it just sounded more sparkling, a bit more refined. I liked it a bit more. Yeah, maybe we can try another track, a bit more bass heavy again.
See the world through a cryptic mind. Can't say I'm sorry. I walk along in a twisted line. Now this weight is a heavy load. Caught in the middle. I'm a saint with a tainted soul. You don't belong, so tell me your name is. You say I'm wrong, so tell me why you're saying. Fire. I'm a killer.
now say that the FIFA Oslo is the better package, better battery life, better capabilities with your phone together. And yeah, of course, being a bit smaller, it is better for outdoors. But if you really want to make a party where you blast them at maximum volume and you want the full bass, I would go with the Copenhagen, as it still has a bit more power. I think you could hear this right now. These are, I think, some artifacts on my microphone, which are caused due to the Bluetooth connections, which of course isn't that great. We also have the B&O M5 here, a highly requested comparison between these two, as they also are quite similar with this fabric here and also size-wise. And now let's connect to the B&O. The B&O is one of my favorite speakers. It sounds very nice. Let's try the bass heavier track again. So yeah, I really like both of them. I think the B&O was a bit more punchy, as it has a bass boost and this huge subwoofer at the bottom, and the FIFA also a bit more precise and of course a bit nicer mids. Let's try the other pop track now.
See the world through a cryptic mind. Can't say I'm sorry. Walk along in a twisted life. Not as weight as a heavy load. Caught in the middle. I'm a slave with a tainted soul. You play along, so tell me what your aim is. You say I'm wrong, so tell me why you're saying.
Now I would definitely give the B&O M5 the edge here. Maybe the Oslo would be more comparable when played in late night, but we already are at about 70%, so maybe late night would cause some distortion with the Oslo. So here the B&O definitely gets the point, as it has this typical B&O punch, this typical B&O atmosphere. And speaking of B&O, I also had a listen to the Biolit 17 today, so the successor to the Biolit 15. But I was very disappointed. Other than a USB Type-C port, you get nothing with this new update, as they call it. Yeah, it's just dumb to buy the speaker. You can find a Biolit 15 for $350 right now, and you have to pay $500 for the new Biolit 17. So this is really a useless update, as it sounds exactly the same as the old version. Let's try a jazz track now, and then I think we are done.
My funny Valentine, sweet comic Valentine, you make me smile with my heart.
I think that B&O really stepped up their game with the M5 here, as it just sounded very nice with this track. Yeah, of course, vocals sounded very great due to the separate mid-range driver, which they now include. Also, the piano was very spacious, the bass rumble sounded very good, but I think nothing can come close with the FIFA Oslo when it comes to jazz music. It just sounded so natural, the vocals were super clear and just super refined, the treble was super sparkling, and the bass of course could be a bit more extended, but maybe this is not the natural way of the sound, so the Oslo just gets the cake with the jazz music, while the B&O is way better with this bass-heavier stuff, with, I don't know, party music or overall pop music, where you just need this kicking bass and this spacious treble. So of course, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like or subscribe to the channel to see more of these videos, especially about the FIFA Oslo. Until then, have a great time and bye bye!